Alright, so I got my gear on and ready to leave Super 88 and get back to JP. So here we go. We just have to get out of the parking lot first, and you know, we're supposed to go around. This is supposedly a one-way kind of path. So we're heading to the back of the parking lot. Alright, so we're almost out of here. It's a little slow going because of the truck in front of us. And, oh, actually, no, he stopped. I guess this guy didn't get the memo that you're supposed to go the other way around. Whatever. No big deal. So, when we get out of Super 88 or 88 Food Connection here, you have to turn right because there's a barrier. So you can't really, you know, wait for the cars to pass and then go to the other side. So you have to turn right here. And what I usually like to do is just turn right again and then right again to, you know, circle around behind Super 88. But as you can see, the person in front of us in the big car or SUV there, you can also bang a UE right there and go backwards. What I like to do is, this is Route 20 by the way, what I like to do is turn right onto whatever street this is. I think it's Winchester or something, I don't know what this is. But anyway, you turn right here, and then at the stop sign coming up, we turn right, I think it's Gardner Street, and then eventually we meet Babcock again. Just turn right again, and it's a pretty simple process. So, you know, no one's coming, let's turn right. So coming up here, this is the back of the Super 88 market where we were just at. And stop sign coming up. And up ahead on the right is Shaw's. So if you wanted to get some other groceries after you finish with the Super 88, you can come on down here. I'm not sure if it costs money to park, but if you're on a scooter, people usually don't care if you say park on the left right there, where the sidewalk is pretty big. I usually don't go in enough places to know where you're allowed to park, but usually if you're on a really big sidewalk, no one's really going to care. Legally, you're not supposed to park if you have a license plate on your scooter. If you have a 50cc scooter, you can seriously park wherever you want, and you should not get a ticket. You got to be a little bit more careful if you have a 125cc scooter with a license plate, because legally you are a motorcycle. Alright, so this is Babcock, and we just turn right here and we keep going. When I first rode up to here, I was thinking of turning left on Commonwealth Avenue or Route 20 right there, but the traffic got a bit heavy, so I decided not to, and I just went straight on Babcock. So if you happen to hear my blinkers on, it's because my original intent was to turn left here, but I decided not to. So we're crossing the tracks, and of course, you know, be really careful at this intersection. Usually people are pretty good about slowing down and stuff, but like this guy here, you know, I guess I was trying to get to the right of this guy this way. I decided not to turn left because, you know, the car was there. So anyway, we're bouncing up and down again on Babcock. For some reason, it's just a little bit better on Babcock going this way. But as you can see in the video, it's still a little bumpy. So, you know, you gotta try it. Life on a scooter. think and see we're getting to the bumpy part of Babcock, which means we're getting pretty darn close to Harvard. So of course watch out for these people who just feel like they're parking on the street. Okay, so we want to be in the left lane because we're turning left onto Harvard Ave. And this is where it probably gets a little busy, and you know, there's gonna be a lot of stops and starts. You just gotta be careful. Now, since this is kind of like a tour video, this might be actually good, so I can, you know, point out a few things, like, you know, there's some kind of restaurant there, and on the right is Citizens Bank. There's a lot of little shops around here, because we're close to Coolidge Corner, and so it's kind of like one of the, you know, fashionable areas and such. There's a Coolidge Corner Theater, I believe, coming up on the right side of Harvard Avenue. And there's some interesting films that get there. Oh, there's a J.P. Licks on the left. That's kind of cool. In case you like ice cream. They got some awesome new types of ice cream. Oh, there's Panera. Anyway, J.P. Licks has some really good ice creams right now. They have hemp ice cream. They have coconut, like coconut cream ice cream made with coconut milk. So that's kind of nice. There's Verizon Wireless on the left. There's a lot of nice little restaurants on the street as well. Anyway, it's a nice place to walk around if you're a tourist, so I recommend coming to this area. So we're back at that big intersection. Of course, be careful. In this case, you want to stay on the right side if you want to keep going down Harvard Avenue. On the left lane, you're supposed to turn left onto Longwood. So, you know, like this guy in the yellow, he probably forgot, and you know that's why he has to cut in front of me. No problem. So just be really careful at these intersections, because sometimes people don't know where they're going, and, you know, whatever. Be cool. And of course, there's this crosswalk right there, so yeah, make sure the pedestrians don't jump in front of me and stuff like that. So, you know, be cool. Alright, so we're scooting down Harvard Avenue again, and as you can see, the road is pretty well maintained. Not too many bumps on the road. So obviously, you know, you got some wealthy people keeping the roads maintained well. So this ride is going to be a little bit more, there's going to be a few more stops and starts, just because for some reason the traffic going south on Harvard Avenue seems to be a bit more busy usually. Unless you're riding at, you know, crazy hours of the day, like, you know, 10 o'clock at night or something. Okay, so on the left you got some more little restaurants and things. I think there's a nice Japanese restaurant called Gari or something like that. That was a pretty good place. I tried it. I think I had a good one or something. And we're coming up to that Stop and Shop where you're allowed to pump gas. So here, you know, scoot off to the right side of the road because you're supposed to turn left on the left lane. And, you know, I'm kind of enjoying these new stoplights they got in the past 4 or 5 years. They actually have timers so that they, you know, you can tell when the light is about to change. It used to be pretty frustrating in this area to, you know, be standing there and then, you know, not knowing when the thing's going to change, and then it changes right when you take one step onto the road. It's kind of a pain in the butt. So anyway, another gas station that's not Stop and Shop to your left. Like I said before, you'll never run out of gas stations. Funny story, one of the first times I, you know, when I first got the scooter, I actually ran out of gas, and I was at the corner of, I think it was Route 20 and Harvard Avenue, so right at the end of this road, going the other way. And I ran out of gas, and I didn't know that there was a Hess gas station, you know, just a couple of blocks away. Oh, by the way, there's Walgreens on the left. And to the left, that's where you would take aspirin to, you know, link up with St. Paul's. Anyway, so when I was, you know, when I ran out of gas there, I actually called for roadside assistance because my buddy 125. I have 2 years of free roadside assistance. So I called, and, you know, and the guy, it took about 45 minutes for the guy to come with the gallon of gas to stick in the tank. And so the guy, you know, pointed out this gas station, which was just a block away. I could have just walked over there and got you know, just walked the bike over there and got the gas. So I felt really dumb. So anyway, the next day I actually went on Google Maps and, you know, found out where all the gas stations were on my to school. And oh my god, there's like a gas station every, you know, couple of blocks. So anyway, that's when I learned that you'll never run out of gas stations. You know, if you run out of gas, it's no big deal. So if you look around here, you know, the Dunkin' Donuts on the right, the Starbucks on the left, the Zoot's dry cleaners. I mean, you know, there's Murphy's Pub on the right side. I mean, this is a really fancy area. I mean, even Dunkin' Donuts looks fancy. So all the store signs are nice and fancy. And of course, the road is nice and fancy, meaning that, you know, it's nicely maintained and all that kind of stuff. All right, so we're just waiting for a traffic light, no big deal. And as you can see, the bike lane goes in the opposite direction too, so if you ride a bicycle in this area, it's pretty sweet. So, okay, we're heading towards Route 9, and you want to be in the right lane, or the middle lane, I guess, because coming up, you know, we're going to turn left, and it might seem that it might be a good idea to be in the left lane, but actually, it's not. And I'll tell you why soon. So this is kind of a bumpy part of the road, so be careful when you're on this part of the road. This is when it starts getting bumpy, I guess. That's when Harvard Avenue ends. Okay, so there's a firehouse up ahead. There's the Arts Institute on the left. Brighton Bank is on the right, and some really brave bicyclists up front there. So we're going to turn left, and the reason you want to be in this lane is because if you're on the left lane, you just got to make one more lane change. I want to be in the right lane after the lights, so that's why I'm left, or in the center lane. You don't really want to be on the right lane because those guys are turning right, and we're trying to turn left here. So anyway, I guess it doesn't matter which you're in, but you know, the center lane seems like a pretty good lane to be in. So, you know, be careful of bicyclists, you know. Alright, so we just gotta make a lane change. Make sure you check your blind spot, and I'm gonna get past this bicyclist so I don't wanna hit over. Alright, lane change. And there we go. Now, if you turn, there's actually access to, I think it's the Jamaica Way, where you get to ride along the Jamaica Pond. That road is kind of fast. I think I ended up on there somehow once, and it scared the hell out of me. I don't think I'll ever do that again. It's almost like being on a freeway, except you're riding along a pond. Or riding by a pond. It's a really nice drive, but, you know, riding a scooter on that road is kind of dangerous. Or it feels dangerous anyway. It might be totally safe. It's just that I'm a chicken. So, alright, let's go up, and we're scooting on down Route 9, and up front we will meet South Huntington Street. So, again, be careful, these bicycles stay on the left third of the lane, if you see one. And there's that Citgo with the expensive gas on the right, with a walk and talk Chinese restaurant. I guess it's cool to be able to pump gas and get Chinese food afterwards. So if you go straight, you know, forward on this road, which is Huntington, actually, you'll get to the Longwood area, and then on Longwood Avenue, you would just turn left if you need to go to the hospital or Harvard Medical School or, you know, those kinds of places. All the hospitals are concentrated there, so it's a good place, all the teaching hospitals. Alright, so we're turning right on South Huntington Street, and, you know, be careful of big trucks parked by. Make sure they see you if you're passing. Alright, so this is also a bike lane, so be careful of bicycles if you see any, but the thing is, I want to stay in the right lane in this case, because there's kind of a weird fork in the road coming up, and so if you want to go to Heath Street, I think I need to stay in the left lane. But I'm turning right now to South Huntington. So this is a weird intersection, be careful, I'm kind of moving people off here. So I think this is actually the Mission Hill area still. I'm not sure when we it's kind of vague as to when one town ends and one town starts. Alright, so there's that hospital on the left. Just be aware of these things so that you know what kinds of vehicles are jumping out in front of you from time to time. And so since this video was taken in the middle of the day, there isn't much traffic here. But during rush hours, this can get clogged, which is why I take it to come from school usually. This can get pretty clogged a little bit. Okay, so we're coming up to that strange intersection. If you saw my previous video, there's a 7-Eleven on the left here. I don't know if you saw it. I think if you, on the left, if you take this crazy angle, I think it's like a, I don't know, 60 degree angle to the left. Not really sure how you would actually get on there. I think you would actually turn left back there and just get into 7-Eleven and then try to turn left on the center. But anyway, this is Center Street that's at a weird angle to us, and we're staying on this street, which is Center Street, so I guess South Huntington becomes Center Street at about this point. And I'm pretty sure we're in Jamaica Plain now. There's a school, right, I think. That's what school is. And on this street, you want to be careful of, you know, cars just jumping out. Hey, there's more gas stations, of course. I think there's another one on the next block, so. Like I said, you'll never run out of gas stations. There's a lot of little businesses here. It's a residential area mainly, but you got a lot of businesses, you know, very small businesses here. So like I said, there's a guy on the right, so make sure he sees you before you can go on to the gas station. Oh, and another gas station up front. So like, in a very small stretch, we've already seen three gas stations on the right side. So don't worry about running out of gas on this road. You'll be taken care of. So there's one there. Be interesting to see what kind of differences in prices they have. You would think that they would have the same prices, right? I'd hope so, anyway. Anyway, so, you know, we're in the town of SUVs. There's one in front of us. There's all kinds of SUVs all over the place for some reason. People around here don't seem to like to ride small cars, like smart cars. I've seen a bunch of Volkswagen Beetles, but, you know, for the most part, people seem to really like their SUVs, and, you know, there's some scooterists. Oh, there's a guy on the right trying to get in, so I guess I should probably let the guy in first. No big deal. He's a big car, you're a small scooter. Let him go, all right? Alright, here we go. So, we're on our way to Green Street. Hopefully, it doesn't take too long. Actually, there is a bit of a traffic jam, even though it's maybe, you know, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and for some reason, this road just gets blocked all the time. Again, that's why I usually don't take this road on the way home if I'm coming from school. Alright, so here we go. We're heading towards Green Street, hopefully. There are more small businesses, like 10 Tables on the right, I heard is really good. on the corner up front by the sign there, there's a JP Comics store now. I didn't know about that. There's a place called Grass Fed right here, directly to my right here, on the corner. It used to be called Bon Savoir, which is a French restaurant, but now it's some kind of organic burger place called Grass Fed, where I think they use beef that's, you know, only been grass fed. I think there's a dentist's office to the left coming up. There's a Gentle Dental. I think I used to go there. Cafe Society, I've never been there, but I'm sure it's a really interesting place. Okay, so there's Gentle Dental on the left, right there. Some automotive place on the left after that. And we're finally getting up pretty close to the corner of Green Street and Center Street. This is kind of a busy intersection, just because people coming from the Jamaica Way are probably coming from the right there, through a bunch of side streets. So on the left there you have the ASPCA or some kind of animal hospital, or maybe it's a people hospital, I don't know, I've never been there. To the right, there's actually a church that is pretty new, like it got rebuilt. On the far right corner, that's the Jamaica Plain Post Office. And on the left there, we have some kind of dry cleaners, which is a pretty good place. So I just realized that the hospital isn't an animal. It's actually a person hospital. It's a health center. So anyway, beside the post office on your right is going to be JP Licks. That's the flagship store. So if you want to see where Jamaica Plains JP Licks first started, that's where it started. And it's still there. On the left is called Same Old Place, which is a really good pizza place. It's very simple pizza, nothing complicated. They sell other things too, like sandwiches and fish and chips, that sort of thing. And then there's another branch of City Feed and Supply on the left, and we're actually going to turn left up front. Watch out for this car coming out of parking. I think she's going to turn left as well, so I'm just going to follow her. The Purple Cactus has some really good burritos or wraps or whatever you think they are. There's Bank of America on the right. So anyway, we're going to turn left onto, I think it's Seaburn Street. And this is basically the faster way to get out of here and bypass the rest of Center Street, because it's basically a very clogged road, kind of like Harvard Avenue, but even more so. So you just want to get out of there, if possible, and turn left. And stick to the left. This is a one-way street, so you don't have to worry about oncoming traffic. So just keep going on this road, and eventually we will get up to Amory Street, and I'm going to show you where Doyle's Pub is when we get there, and I'm going to show you English High, which was supposed to be the setting for that show that used to be on the air called Boston Public. So anyway, there's a stop sign here. Make sure you watch out for the traffic here, because there are streets in weird angles, so it's kind of a strange example of how the cow paths created roads in Boston. So anyway, people are usually pretty friendly here, like back there. I wanted to let the lady go first, but she said, no, you go first, and that's kind of the way it is around here. So anyway, this is Amory Street at the stop sign, so look left, look right, and there's a lot of pedestrians, and there's a bike path to the right and to the left, I guess. So, you know, just be careful, don't run anybody over, and be cool. So, sometimes bicyclists don't like to look where they're going, so just make sure that you're looking where you're going. And so we're turning right onto Amory Street, and there's another scooter, hey! And to the left, there's a kind of office building. It's kind of, a bunch of little businesses. watched that show called Lost in the Public, supposedly, that took place here. So this is William Street, so we're just going to turn left onto William Street. And so to the right is St. Michael, and to the left is the ball field where they play football, baseball, and soccer, and whatever. Now, at the stoplights, I'm going to show you where the famous Doyle's Cafe is. So that's where all the politicians hang out, apparently. It's a very famous tourist spot, too. So recently, if you look at that white trolley car parked there on the corner there, that actually is a tour trolley that takes you to the Sam Adams Brewery. So I don't know how much it costs. But basically, the trolley takes you to the Sam Adams Brewery, you go on the beer tour, you pay $2 suggested donation for the 7-ounce beer glass, you drink a lot of beer. I think they're only allowed to give you 21 ounces at any one sitting, so they don't really watch you or anything, so whatever. Anyway, so for $2 you can taste three types of beer, and you know, that's a pretty good deal, right? And then I think the trolley car takes you back to Doyle's where you get glass, so I guess you pay more for the tour or something, I don't know. Anyway, that's Doyle's Cafe on the left, and we're back on William Street, and this is the end of your video scooter tour. I'm the poor student, thanks for watching, and see you next time.